Praise God, praise God. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you are having a blessed day in the Lord. Hallelujah to his name. As you can see my title, it says that the number one job of Satan is to bring down the people of God, especially leaders, especially those that are anointed, especially those that are appointed. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Ain't nobody playing up in here. I'm talking about it is time for you to understand what is going on and why it's going on. God said that you have to be unmovable, steadfast. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So, let me slow it down just a moment. I'm just so, oh man, I tell you, when I start to do these lives, I pray before and I anoint myself and I just ask God to just use me. Use me, Lord. Don't look at me, but have the spirit of the living God. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. Well, in the last days, they are planning so much death, destruction, said the Lord. They want martial law. Lord, they want y'all guns. I'm telling you, that's what they really want. They want your guns. You think I'm lying? I'm lying. Let me tell you something. Praise God, praise God. Let me slow down. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit, get a hold. I'll just boo. Let me tell you something, what they're trying to do. If they can snatch y'all guns, martial law is coming. They know America's not going to just give up their guns. Do y'all know that we have more guns than people in America? Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all ain't ready for me, I'm telling you. So they already know that you guys are not going out without a fight. Or us, you could say. And so what they're trying to do is that's why these fake hits and these fake, we're going to say catastrophes. You know, the FBI have a different report about Sandy Hook. Y'all know that, right? They're saying that nobody died at Sandy Hook. Y'all ain't ready for me. I'm talking about FBI reports. Even in Orlando, you remember that gay club that got shot up? They say that nobody died until they got there. So I don't know. I wasn't there, but that's two different reports. We're talking about FBI reports. And for those that don't know my background, when I first started college, I actually worked for the FBI for a couple of years. I guess God had some other things. That's why I know a lot, you guys. I saw a lot, and I'm telling you, the pieces just coming together. And I wonder why God didn't let me pursue that career. I'm telling you, it's a lot going on. And a lot of Christians, oh God, are just oblivious to the fact. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. And I blame these pastors, these preachers, these teachers, these leaders, because they got y'all wanting to just be branded. They got y'all wanting to look successful. They got it to where now the thing is, everybody has to be successful. Successful. Let me tell you, what is success? Because God says, I pray that you prosper, but even by your soul that prospers. Come on, somebody. So it's not just about financial. But churches have it to where if you don't have a mega church, and if you're not a mega this or doing it on a mega level, then you're not anointed. The devil is a lie. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. God appoints and anoints who he wants to. And you can always tell because it's a us versus them. Oh, you don't hear what I'm saying. They might have more money. They might have mega, but they ain't got no power. Come on, somebody. Don't play with me in this hour. Hallelujah. So let me go ahead and start what I'm saying. Every person in the Bible that was powerful, what did they use to bring him down? I'm talking about Satan. We're talking about Samson and Delilah right now. Let me read a little story to you about Delilah. And I want y'all to know, everything is in a name. Everything is in a name. If you want to know who you are, it is in your name. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Go actually Google it in the Greek. Come on, somebody. And even in the Hebrew language, you'll find out who you are. And it is in a name. That's why back in the biblical days and in the beginning, they named them a certain name because that's what the spirit that came up on them by that name. Delilah, a lie from the gate. Okay, so let's talk about this strange woman. Delilah was a woman of Sorek. She was the only woman in Samson's story who was named. The Bible says that Samson loved her, Judges 16:4. But you know, that was my first sermon ever about Samson and Delilah. And one thing that God told me is, if you search them scriptures, Delilah never says she loved Samson, but he said he loved her. Let me tell you something. That's how they get most strange. That's how they get most preachers, by these strange women. They send them in there looking all sexy, all, y'all know what I'm saying, and vice versa for you women. Oh, he's so fine. As a matter of fact, some of y'all go to the church just because he's fine. Don't play with me. You know what I'm saying. You're not even thinking about the message. You send up this one, hallelujah, yeah, whatever. You better rebuke that spirit of lust on you. That's what you better do. That's this stuff real. This stuff real. So let me continue. But she didn't love him. The two were not even married. And the idea is that they had sexual relationship. And that's in, you know, they don't say that in that biblical text, but that's biblical applications. That's what they were pretty much having sex. All right, so let's talk about Delilah, also spelled Dalia, Dalila. Almost like a lie, huh? L-I-A. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. In the Old Testament. The central figure of Samson's last love story. She was a Philistine woman who bribed to entrap Samson. Coaxed him into revealing what was the secret of his strength was his long hair. Whereupon she took advantage of his confidence to betray him to his enemies. That is that same spirit that's on the earth today. That is exactly what's happening today. And some of you will tell them your secret. Let me tell you something. If somebody asking you your secret, you ought to be looking at them like, why you want to know? You don't hear what I'm saying. Even people that are trying to get close to you. I said this and I'll say this in a couple. I'll probably say this to the day I die. You're supposed to, when you meet somebody, pray. This a lie. This will tell you anything. This will tell you what you want to hear. But I promise you, if you ask God, God, show me their spirit. Show me what they want. Show me who they are. You'd be surprised. Oh my God, the dreams that I've had about people. And I said, okay, I ain't fooling with them. You ain't got to worry about me, God. Hallelujah. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. So notice the Bible says that Samson kept messing with Delilah until he didn't even know that God had left him. Oh, come on, somebody. Now I'm about to go in. Let me tell you something. There are so many people preaching in a pulpit and God has left you. You don't even know that he's gone. And let me tell you why, because it's reprobate mind. You see, let me tell you how the Holy Spirit works. And I think you understand this. Only if you have the spirit of the Holy Ghost will you understand completely what I'm saying. When you are endowed with the Holy Ghost will tell you, don't say that. Don't do that. Don't go here. Don't respond like this. Don't do that. But when you lose, understand me, when you lose the sense of conviction, that means that you've been doing that thing a long time. Now you get into a reprobate mind. What is reprobate? That means that you can't even hear anymore. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. And God says, I'll give you over to that thing. What does the Lord mean when he said that? That means I'll make sure that you can't hear and see me. And I'll give you that thing that you want, because here's the deal. That thing will destroy you. And God will let it. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. This is a warning. This is a warning. This is a warning, thus said the Lord. Be mindful of who you allow in your life. Be mindful of who you fall in love with. Be mindful of who you're friends with. Be mindful, saith the Lord. Hallelujah to his name. Because they're trying to kill you. They're trying to destroy you. They're trying to steal from you. You don't hear what I'm saying. Because if they ain't coming this way, they're trying to get your resources. If they ain't trying to get your resources, they're trying to taint you. If they're not trying to taint you, they're trying to pull you away from God. Hallelujah. Anybody or anything that tries to take you from your God is your God. You don't hear what I'm saying, because now you done turned your back on God and it made them your God. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. And let me tell you something. They will come in the area that you need most. Financial, all of a sudden somebody want to bless you with a lot of money. You better be careful. Oh, come on, somebody, hallelujah. I am so serious. Hallelujah. This stuff is real. I don't care, even if it's love. Some women are so desperate and some men are so desperate that you are just looking and looking and looking. Can I tell you something? You know what you're supposed to do? The Bible says that he who finds a wife. Oh, come on, somebody, y'all are gonna like me today. Women, you just too flimsy and shimsy. Oh, come on, somebody, you know what I'm saying. And so exposed. Let me tell you something. A lady is supposed to keep herself covered. You ain't gonna see me uncovered. Even when I was young, I didn't like that. Come on, somebody, because guess what? They still gonna love you one way or another, and then you wonder why they treat you the way they treat you, because guess what? You don't have no respect for yourself. Hallelujah. It goes back to the beginning. It goes back to the beginning. Satan cannot do anything unless you allow him to, says the Lord. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. You have to love yourself. You have to have respect for yourself. And you can only do that by the Spirit of God, because the flesh wants you to act a fool. The flesh wants you to act like, oh, come on, I'm going to say it. I'm going to say it. I'm going to say it. Because they have it in the Bible. Okay? I ain't gonna say the dry version. I'm going to say what they have in the Bible. God says that you go whoring after strange things, after strange men, after lust, after money, after success. Some of you will do anything to get that dollar. Y'all know what I'm saying. Hallelujah to his name. And you'll wonder why the younger generation is after that dollar. That's all they see. And guess what? They won't respect you unless you have a dollar. You don't hear what I'm saying. As God is saying in this last hour, I'm bringing my people back to me to where they respect the word of God. Because let me tell you what the enemy wants to do. The enemy wants to, he wants to kill the spirit of the saints. He wants to kill Christianity. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm going to go a little left with this. That's where New World Order come in. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Why are you thinking I'm going here? And let me tell you something. Let me do my disclaimer. I don't love nobody. However, I hate what God hates, and I don't care who you are. You are not supposed to be lying with a man. Hallelujah. And if you're a man, you ain't supposed to lie with a woman. If you're a woman, what's wrong with you? Come on, somebody. Don't tell me you was born that way. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you what they're trying to do. They're trying to make it to so to where, guess what? It is so acceptable that it is that for the Christians, that's how they're going to get arrested. Let me tell you what they're going to try to do, okay? They're going to make all these things laws. They're overturning all God's laws. And so now it's going to be a sin for you to say anything against them. That's why I'm not affiliated. Oh, I'm about to go here. I don't have a 501(c), because guess what? You ain't gonna harness me. That's why I don't have it. Oh, come on, somebody. I remember I was in California, and I'm not lying. I have witnesses. This guy gave me keys to a whole church. I said, no, thank you. No, thank you, because I understand what y'all want to do. Y'all trying to silence me. You wanna muzzle me. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Because they muzzle you. Oh, they give them that money. Why you think they can talk about it? So, oh, y'all thought they just would. No. They can't. There are the laws that have been written for like 7-8 years ago that they cannot talk about certain things, because if they do, the IRS and everybody else going to be knocking on their door. Hallelujah. John Hagee used to get hit with all them fines and laws. So they can't even talk about it. So my thing is this. So why did they even accept that if they knew that it was going to bind them? Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But God said, I got 7,000 that won't be bounded. Oh, you don't hear what I'm saying. I'm one of them. You ain't going to muzzle me. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And hold on. They'll even allow saints to try to come. Oh, well, you know, maybe you shouldn't do it this way. Maybe don't take that much. The devil is a liar. That's why you falling. Hallelujah. Because guess what? Somebody didn't tell you the truth. Somebody didn't tell you was dirty. Somebody didn't tell you was nasty. Let me tell you something. When you truly have the love of God, you want to get better. Please tell me about myself if it is of God. Hallelujah. We playing too much with people. Oh, they're going to be all right. Oh, I'm going here tonight. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Let me tell you something. Just like y'all got these, I was about to say the bad word, faggots, all right? But I'm going to say homosexuals. I'm just going to be real because I'm whole school. I'm sorry if you get affected, if you get offended. Y'all got them singing, spewing out their spirit. And then when your little boy come to you, well, I don't know what I want to be. Because that spirit that came into, y'all don't hear, y'all don't understand how the anointing works, huh? Whatever you listen to, whatever you take in, you take in. That's why you have to gird your spirit. And y'all wondering why the little girls and the little boys don't know who they want to be. And guess what? They got it in the schools now. Gender. They call it gender. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Hallelujah. And God going to get some of you. Oh, I must say, God going to get some of you, because some of you pastors on the low. Let me tell you something. I learned a lot when I was in L.A. I learned a lot. I see how they flow. There is an organization. Oh, God, they're not going to like me. They're not going to like this. And if I start naming the top names in the gospel community, y'all will cringe. They are low gay. I don't know where they started this. No, I'm going to go here, the Boule. Oh, y'all ain't ready for me. What is the Boule? Those are the most prestigious black men and women of the world. Yes, that's right. The Boule is the one that keep the church in order. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. That's the ones that taint the church. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Because guess what? They won't let you in mainstream unless you're doing something that you ain't got no business. Oh, yeah, I'm going to tell her. I'm going to tell her. I ain't scared. You know I ain't scared, right? Hallelujah. Now, if you're scared, you know what to do. Hallelujah. So now you got everybody. Well, if we want to be on TV, we got to do this. What y'all think would happen to Eddie Long? You think them people didn't know? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. They knew. I'm sorry. How you not going to know and you and in the midst of them? If I come, if we are friends, I'm going to break it down like this. Don't you know what your friends do? Even if they try to lie about it, y'all talk about it behind their back, huh? Because y'all know, hello, that's the same thing. Don't tell me they didn't know. The devil is a lie. And let's go here. The Holy Spirit going to reveal you anyway. Stop lying. You just ain't going to say nothing too much. That's if you that type of person. But I'm going to tell you the truth. That's why probably my friends come and go. Because don't come around me lying, cooking and crooking. Because I promise you, I'm going to tell you about yourself. And you have the right to tell me too if you see something. Please help me. See, I ain't scared. If y'all see something, please help me. Tell me so I can get better and not bitter and not try to hide, crook, and lie. Because God hates that. He said, repent. And he said, confess your faults one to another. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And let me tell y'all something, too. It's another thing. I noticed like a lot of you are asking me, am I available to chat? I'm not talking to you unless God tell me to. I don't know you. Come on, somebody. And then I don't get offended because some of y'all might get hurt. Y'all always in my messenger talking about, are you available to chat? Are you crazy? Don't be asking me nothing like that. And I don't know you. And then I got to go to God and ask God. Because you might be a whole with your warlock on the other side of that phone. Then I'm about to tell you something. You're going to really get mad. Yeah, I'm on one today. Can you chat? You don't even know me like that. No, you don't. I am a sister in Christ, but you don't know me. But you should. Huh? How you doing? So, That's all God told me to tell you. Yeah, I be on one. I ain't lying. Because I do this for real. I don't do this for play. That's what's wrong with people playing. I don't have time to play. You don't have time to play. I know you think you do. You better look out here and see what's going on. The devil is here. And he's trying to take all of us with him. He's trying to knock us down. He's sending this one. He's sending that one. He's sending this. He's sending that. And y'all got to do like the Matrix. You got to block them things. This stuff real. This is not a game. It's like Monopoly. Everything that they showed us, Clue, Monopoly, all those games is really real, huh? So I pray that you understand. Guard your gates. Guard your heart. Test everything. I test everything. I don't, no. And let me tell you something. You don't let people just in your life like that. No, I don't care if they got something that you want. Ask God. God, did you send that? Because that could be just a whole ploy. Come on, somebody. That's how people are falling. Stop eating from people you ain't got no business eating from. Come on, somebody. And trust me, I had to learn that. Because you know when you like to eat, oh, I'll put myself on blast. That's why I'm exercising, trying to, because you know being a chef, you want to taste everything. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about what I cook. I don't taste everybody else's stuff. But still in all, same rule applies. So I just want y'all to understand the seriousness of everything that's happening. These people are getting ready for martial law. As a matter of fact, New World Order is already here. A lot of y'all say it's not. Yes, it is. It's just a soft. You ever heard of a soft run and a hard run? Come on, somebody. You know what a soft run is? We doing it and they don't even know it. Don't worry, it's going to get hard in a minute. It's going to get real hard in a minute. Y'all going to be looking for prophets like me. Y'all ain't going to be looking for them fake ones no more. See, them fake ones, you know, they mainstream. Let me tell you something. They don't let no real ones be mainstream. And if y'all haven't gotten that one yet, I don't know what to say to you. I don't know what to say to you. And again, don't get offended. But a lot of y'all, can you chat? Look what you should be saying. God, should I even contact her and say that to her? Because if y'all know me or get to know this channel and my demeanor, I don't do anything without God. I can't. I don't care what the situation is. Not that I don't care. Somebody tried to call me. I got to be mindful because I know the enemy don't like me and I don't like him. So rather than that, I got to watch it. I'm watchful. The Bible say, watch and be sober. Hello? So God bless you. God keep you. I pray that y'all understand. It's hot out here. You got to be full of the Holy Ghost to win. You cannot be playing in this hour. Please stop playing because so many of y'all playing. Y'all just run after that money. You better run after God because in a minute, the dollar bill is already diminishing the value. That's not going to be nothing in a minute. So you're running after stuff that's not going to be anything. Run after God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, and your spirit. Hallelujah to his name. So God bless you. This is Apostle. And yes, somebody had to say that. You are right. Let me tell you something. I told y'all, and I really feel this way. I feel that, and I think I can say this. I was one of the ones that awoke in everybody. 7-8 years I've been talking about martial law stuff. People thought I was crazy. They don't think I'm crazy no more, huh? But one of the things that I told people is that man in office, that last president, I promise you, he wasn't supposed to leave office. I think they did that because I'm telling you, my prophecies were strong. And I already told y'all I went before God, so we ain't got to talk about it. But that is who they're going to use for the New World Order. And I know y'all don't like it. Who ushered in the gay rights? Who ushered in the gay movement? See, some of you Christians just looking at color. Who ushered in? Because the Bible says that we hate what he hate. The Bible says that it's an abomination. Y'all got to look at the Bible. And all you got to do is go in chapter Daniel. Or go in the book of Daniel. And that Daniel going to describe all who it is and what's going on. But some of you, you know, you better quit with that tradition stuff. And you better ask God. Think it's a game. All right. Thank you, God bless you. Hallelujah to y'all. Oh, God, glory, glory, glory. I feel the power of God. God is so good. Thank you, Jesus. He going to be there. He said, don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. Stay in your Bible. Stay in your word. Do not fear. I keep hearing do not fear. That's why they're shooting a lot of the black men. Y'all don't understand. They're trying to impose fear on y'all. Fear on your women. Fear on the culture. Fear on other people. Let me tell y'all something. Do not fear the enemy. Do not fear the enemy, says the Lord. For I am with you. I will fight for you. I will go before you. I will thwart them. Hallelujah. God is not playing. Just stand strong, says the Lord. All right, this is Apostle Deanna Dixon. You are a soldier of the living Christ. Act like it, walk like it, talk like it, be like it, in Jesus' name. Roll out soldiers, for that is who you are. God bless.